Halloumi Nubi. She was the crazy lady that decided to drive all the way from London to Lagos. I had the pleasure of meeting her last month in Dubai, and I learned some gems from her. Hi, my name is Chichi. I discuss all things fashion, faith, and entrepreneurship. First of all, I'm going to be sharing video clips from Halloumi Nubi.
And my mission was always to showcase that traveling can be easy, safe, and doable, especially as a solo female black traveler. That was something I wanted to put out there. You can seek adventure, you can do audacious things.
Okay, so number one, have a strong why. What exactly is driving you in your business or at work to start your personal brand? Whatever the case may be, I find that when people don't really have a strong why, they're just a little bit too comfortable. They think they're doing really well, they think that they're making progress, and maybe they are, but I feel like they could be making more progress if their why was strong enough. And I'm speaking to myself because I feel like I've been in positions in the past where I really wanted something, I was just too comfortable. I know so many people that had pretty much nothing. Now they're millionaires. Their why was to get their family out of the situation they were in. That brings me on to the next point of having a strong why. Then your why is more people focused. It's outside of yourself. The why is just that bit stronger. The drive is just that bit more. Most people are willing to accept difficult situations or circumstances when it's just them. Just like, okay, I'm willing to like eat a bit more unhealthily when it's just me. But when I'm feeding my son, I'm like, no, I will 100% go that extra mile. When it's people we love, that drive is just a bit more magnified. I put my why as my screensaver on my phone as like a vision board that I can see all the time. When you see something all the time, it's like, oh, it just reminds you that, gosh, I really want my situation to change.
So, you know, it got to a point whereby Mr. Kunle, I think I mentioned the biker that did from London to Lagos by bike, used a different route. And I went down the rabbit hole of, has a woman done this before? You know, per usual, very curious of me. And I didn't. I did not see, there was no data, there was no published, you know, publication out there. So I was like, you know, it's 2024, we need to not be having these new titles. So I decided to go and do something audacious.
Be curious. Halloumi went down a rabbit hole, as she called it. A lot of us just accept things as they are. We don't ask questions, because if we did, we might just find out that there are so many possibilities for us to contribute positively or us to put our stamp on something in some way. But I think a lot of us can't be bothered, or we just accept the status quo. Like, oh, okay, he did it, great. You don't even consider how you could possibly make something better, how you could possibly add to something and make an impact. When we don't ask questions, we don't identify the problem or a gap in the market or an area that we could solve. So we miss it. That's because we well and truly weren't really looking for it in the first place. We weren't curious. That was a big one for me, because I think you find that actually when you look and study successful people, a lot of them have, they've discovered a problem and then they've solved it. They've been the person to provide the solution. And a lot of us sometimes expect the problem to drop in our lap. And I think to some degree it does, but to some degree we need to explore, we need to go further, and we need to be like, oh, hang on, let's do our research, let's actually look into this a bit more. But I think looking for problems could be actually the key to unlock our opportunity.
Audacious, something crazy, which is my favorite thing to be called, by the way. Like, I always tell people, that's like my tagline, you know, if they don't call you crazy, you're playing it too safe.
Incredible, right? So the whole saying of no risk, no reward, I guess, sort of rings true in this case. Honestly, the amount of people who are now successful that when you think about it, if you were there at the time, people would call them a failure. So the fact that Steve Jobs and Bill Gates both decided to drop out of college or university, as we call it in the UK, like, I can't even imagine telling my parents, yeah, guys, mom and dad, I'm dropping out of university to pursue something else. They would have looked at me like I was crazy. You know how African families are. Nobody wants their family to be looking bad. Everybody's trying to keep up appearances. And well and truly, dropping out of university, I would have looked like a failure. Failure is something I've come to realize successful people are almost immune to. They have failed so many times. And I think we always hear this, but when you actually delve deep into their story and hear it from them, you realize it's true. Not being scared to fail. That's something I've definitely learned from starting my business, is not being scared to fail. I have failed so many times, but I've got back up again. There needs to be an element of risk. People calling you crazy because it just seems so risky. If you're too comfortable, a lot of people pivot entirely from what they've studied at college or university, and they go on to become super successful. They're definitely not playing it safe. Imagine going on to college or university, studying for 7 years, and then deciding, do you know what? I'm going to do something totally different. That is definitely not playing it safe. That is definitely crazy. I hear so many stories about people doing this. I mean, I watched a TikTok yesterday of a medic who is thinking of dropping out to pursue hair. She's like, ugh. She's doing her hair thing on the side, and she's just like, oh, she really loves doing hair, but she's conflicted. So, and there's so many stories of that. I mean, I'm said story, I guess. You know, I'm a dentist, for those that don't know, a dental surgeon, and I'm trying to pursue a career in fashion. So, you know, but for me, ultimately, I feel from a Christian perspective, that's why one of my favorite scriptures is, Lord, be a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. And I love that scripture because it's just, I'm such a visual person and I can just see God showing me every step. So he lights up one step and I put my foot there. He lights up another step and then I put my foot there. And he shows you part of the journey, one step at a time, but it requires some level of faith, I guess, you know, that to take that first step. And that could be so difficult. It could be so difficult. And there's constant wars with people calling you crazy and like, oh, but I've been studying science my whole life. What on earth am I doing in fashion now? I have no network. And honestly, for me, it's been a constant pull, to be honest. And it's actually quite nice that I'm discussing and sharing it with you guys here. But then it gets to this point where you're just like, no, I honestly believe that so long as I'm following him super closely, like tightly as ever, like we are Siamese twins at this point, I will be fine. And that I'm actively hearing from God, so that every step I take is by faith. But I've got the backing of the Holy Spirit. I've got the backing of God. Because at this point in my life, guys, I failed so many times in so many different things and areas of my life that I can't afford to fail again. But I also am wired to take so many risks. But these are calculated, divinely blessed risks in Jesus' name. I honestly feel if God is leading you to do something, if you have this constant pull, and even if it sounds crazy, then Palumi was saying that's usually where you should be at, honestly, because if you could do it by yourself, then you wouldn't even need God. Let's be real. I wouldn't need God if I could do so many things by myself. I really would just like, I'm just doing it by myself. Why am I going to pray about it when I could just do it by myself? And, you know, God is a jealous God. He wants us to be so dependent on him. I think risk-taking, getting out of our comfort zone is so good for that. Like, you hold on to God for dear life when you're doing something entirely different, when you're pivoting from something that you've known all your life to something totally new. Even within business, having to pivot in terms of strategy and things like that, it's just so, there's so much to think about. So my encouragement to you, we'll just round this up because it's getting quite long. My encouragement to you is just have a strong why. Be curious, ask questions. I always say the most intelligent children are the ones that ask questions, because if you don't know, how are you going to know? Like, if you don't ask questions, you're never going to know, right? And darling, if they're not calling you crazy, you're playing it too safe. Just take the risk. Take the risk. Honestly, this is only three points that I've learned from Pulumi. There's so many more to come. One of them are my favorite, is one of my favorite points. That will be in another video because this is already so long. If you like this video and you got something out of it, please like, subscribe. And if you think there's somebody else that might like this video, then share it with them as well. And if you are having this pull between your passion and what you're doing now, honestly, just pray about it. Keep going, keep doing it on the side. That would be my advice. And let God lead you as to when to pivot, when to move, when to take the next step. Because ultimately, time and seasons are in His hands. There's a season for everything. That's me. That's all for today. But thank you for tuning in, and I will see you in another video. Bye, guys.